Hello everyone, my name is Narim Attiaras. I am TGT Social Science at Kendra Vidyalaya Imphal number 2. Today I am going to teach a topic from the class 8 Geography chapter number 1. The name of the chapter is Resources. So let's start the chapter. So we are going to start from the introduction. The first sentence of the introduction is the definition of the resource. Anything that can be used to satisfy a need is a resources. Okay, anything that satisfied our needs that we're going to call as a resource. Second, utility or the usability is what make a object or substance a resource. This is the second point is saying that we should be know how to utilize that substance or how to utilize that object. After that, it's going to become the resource. Third point. Some resources have an economic value, some do not. Some, for example, metal may have an economic value and beautiful landscape may not. So all the resources do not have the economic value. Some resources have the economic value and some do not. And those who have an economic value, examples, that is metal, mineral, they have the economic value. And the resource like the landscape, they do not have the economic value. Last point. Time and technology are the two important factors that can change the substances into the resources. There are a lot of examples given in your NCERT textbook, and example of the hydroelectricity, example about invention of new technology. Okay, after the coming of the that technology, there some object going to become the resource. But before the invention of the that technology, that object did not become the resource. Okay. So a lot of examples are given, you just read from the NCERT textbook. Next one, that is the type of resources. There are three types of resources. First one, that is natural resource. Second one, human-made resource. Third one, that is the human resource. Okay, I'm repeating again. We have three types of resources. Natural resource, human-made resource, human resources. Then this natural resource, the first one, again it is classified into the two types. There is renewable resource and the non-renewable resource. There are two types of this natural resource. Okay, so this is the table showing the type of resources. There is a classification of the resource. So one by one we are going to study. First we are going to study about the natural resource, then this type of the natural resource, renewable resource and a non-renewable resource. Then after that we're going to study about the human-made resource, and then lastly we're going to study about the human resource. So let's see in detail of all of this one by one. First one, natural resource. So natural resources. Resources that are drawn from the nature and used without the much modification are called the natural resources. For example, lake, the soil, mineral. That means those resources which are taken from the nature and we use that resource without a much modification, they are all going to be called as a natural resource. But now let's come to the second point. It is a very important one, this second point. That is, the distribution of the natural resources depend upon the number of physical factors like terrains, climate and the altitude. That means all the natural resources are not evenly distributed throughout the world. They are some are distributed, some are available in some places and some are not available in the other places, because it is depend on some factors, physical factors like terrains, climate and altitude. Last point, natural resources can be broadly categorized into the renewable and the non-renewable resources that I already told you in the previous table also. Okay, now let's come to the next one, next topic. This is the one, some picture about the natural resources. Okay, it includes the animal resources, crude oil, forest resources, and the mineral resources. Okay, then the water resource, land resource, wind and solar resource, and the natural gas. These are all taken from the nature. So they are example about the natural resources. Next one, that is the renewable resources. It is a type of the natural resource. Okay, don't forget that renewable resource and non-renewable resource is that type of natural resource. The first one, renewable resource. Renewable resources are those which get renewed or replenished quickly. That means it can be renewed or it can be replenished. That means maybe it reproduce. Okay, that quickly or may quickly. Okay, then the second point. Some of these are unlimited and are not affected by the human activity, such as solar and the wind energy. That means some resources, okay, some of part of these natural renewable resources are unlimited and they are not affected by the human activity, and it includes the solar energy and the wind energy. Next one, non-renewable resources. Non-renewable resources are those which have a limited stock. Once the stock are exhausted, it may take a thousand of the year to renew or replenish. That means once the stock of the this non-renewable resource is finished, it's going to take a thousand of year, more than thousand of year, okay, to renew it or replenish it. And the example of the non-renewable resource include the coal, petroleum and the natural gas. These are some example of this non-renewable resource. So let's see the one picture of regarding the renewable and the non-renewable. The first three are the example of the renewable energy, renewable resource. That is, it includes the solar energy, water and the wind. Then the next, the bottom three is the example of the non-renewable resource. And it includes the phosphate, that is a mineral, oil, example like petroleum, then the limestone. Okay, these are the all the example of the what? Non-renewable. And these first three are top one. They are the example of the renewable resource. Next is the human-made resource. And the first point of the human-made resource is, sometimes natural substances become a resources only when their original form has been changed. Second, that is the definition of the human-made resources. People use natural resources to make the building, bridge, roads, machinery, and vehicle, which are known as the human-made resources. That means we use our buildings for office or for the living, bridge for crossing the river, road for transportation, machinery for in the industry, vehicle for the transportation. These are all what human-made resources, because these are all technology or these are all resources that is made by the human. Then another one, that is the technology, is also a human-made resource. So here we have the part of the human-made resource, and this is the one diagram related with the human-made resources. That is, people use natural resources to make a building, bridge, road, machinery, and vehicle, which are known as the human-made resources. And the picture about here we have a picture of industry. Okay, then this is also industry. Then we have a picture of buildings. Then the picture about the air transportation. Okay, related with the human-made resources. Now let's come to the next one. Next topic, that is the human resources. Human resources refers to the number, that is a quantity, and ability, that is a mental and a physical of the people. Okay, so human resource is going to include two things. First one, that is the number, how many number, okay, there is a population of the human, a population of the peoples. Okay, then the there is a next one, that is the ability, how much they are skilled or how much they are educated, because here it is written as the mental and the physical also. The physically fit is also be needed here. Okay, then the second point, people can make the best use of the nature to create a more resource when they have the knowledge, skill and the technology to do so. That means we can make a best use of our nature only when we have the what? Knowledge, we have a skill, then we then last one, when we have the technology. And last one, improving the quality of the people's skill so that they are able to create a more resource is known as the human resource development. That means giving a more knowledge or giving a more skill training, okay, or improving the technology, or that okay, we going to be included, they are all going to be included in this human resource development. Okay, because it is here the simple words they are saying is that improving the quality of the people skill. Now let's come to the one diagram related with the human resources, that is human resource going to include the recruiting performance of the people, training of the people, research work, skill development or skill, then employee potential of the people, then leadership. These are all the element there, or we can say as the that thing that related with the human resources. Last topic of this chapter, there is conserving resources. First point, there is the definition of conserving resources, that is using resources carefully and giving them time to get renewed is called resource conservation. That means using a resource carefully, okay, not wasting, and giving it time to renew it, that we going to be called as the resource conservation. Second one, it is a definition of sustainable development. It is a very important balancing the needs to use resources and also conserve them for the future is called the sustainable development. The meaning of sustainable development is that optimum utilization of the resource, that means how much you have needed, only use that much, okay, and the conserve for the future generation, that we going to be called as the resource sustainable development. Then how a common people, okay, how do people like me or you going to be contribute in the, or how can we contribute in the this resource conservation? What shall we do? Okay, we can do reducing the consumption, then we can recycle it, then we can reuse the thing. These are the three R. First one, that is a reducing, second one is the recycling, and the third one is the reusing. This we can do for the resource conservation. Okay, here again the picture is a picture about it, that three R. First one, that is the recycle, second one is the reuse, and the third one, that is the reduce. So here we finish the part of this topic. Now last one, that is I'm giving you some homework. There are four questions. First question, let's see why are resources distributed unevenly over the earth? Okay, you have to read that part of the resource and a natural resource. There I have given you that natural resource distributed unevenly because of the some physical factor. Okay, what are that factor? You just read that part of the natural resource. Then the second question, what is resource conservation? I have given you the definition of resource conservation. Okay, there is reducing, or that is use up to the needs and then conserve for the, or give a time for the renew. Then question number three, why are human resources important? Okay, why human resources are important? You have to write that definition of human resource. Okay, it is because of that human resource, that things like the building or a machine or road, then the vehicles are going to be built. Okay, then the last question, what is sustainable development? And the definition of sustainable development is also given in that part of the conserving resource. That is using a resource, that is the amount of resource that we have needed, then conserve for the future generation. Okay, that definition is given in that part. Just read it. So thank you everyone. Stay home and stay safe. Thank you.